We are going to do the quick review of the lesson tissues. There are main points. Living organism in this world comprise of the cells. There are unicellular as well as multicellular organisms present in this world. In unicellular organism, the only single cell is capable of performing several functions like respiration, digestion and clearing of the cell. But in case of multicellular organisms, there is a division of labor. There are different types as a group of cells that perform different functions in multicellular organism. For example, animal muscle cells are responsible for causing movement. Nerve cells are responsible carrying the messages and signals from one body part to the another. Blood is also involved in transportation of the food and oxygen to the different parts of our body. In case of the plant, there are vascular tissues that are responsible for carrying food and water to the different parts of the plant. Thus, how the formation of the tissue takes place. The cells form the group of the cells that need to perform a single task upon group together. And this grouping of the cell together to perform functionally efficiently is called as a tissue. For example, muscles, blood, bone, epithelial tissues, meristematic tissues, vascular tissues means xylem and phloem. These are different types of the tissues present in living things. Now, we are going to see about tissues of the plants and animal. We will see the differentiation of plant tissue and animal tissue. For that, we will go first for the plant tissue. The plants do not move, so their tissues are predominantly the one that provide support to them so that they can stand erect. These tissues are made up of dead cells because dead cells can also provide mechanical strength to the plant and do not require much maintenance. Only certain parts of the plant can grow. The tissue present in such regions divide themselves and form new tissues. The structure of the plant tissue is not very specialized as compared to the plant. Now, we are going to see about animal tissue. Animals need more energy as compared to the plants because they are not stationary, means they move from one place to another place. The tissues in case of animals are made up of living cells so that they can move and perform several functions. The cells in animals grow uniformly early and not only in the certain regions of the body. The organs and organ system in animals are highly developed. Thus, these are some important distinguishing point between plant and animal tissue. Now, we will see the mind map of this plant tissue, means how the classification of the plant tissue takes place. Here, from this concept map, you can see there are mainly two types of the plant tissue. Plant tissue, they are classified as meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. These meristematic tissues divide throughout the life, but permanent tissue lost ability to divide further. In case of meristematic tissue, these are again three types depending upon position, means where they are present. The tissues or the meristematic tissues which are present at the tip portion of the stem, root, or leaf. It is called as apical meristem. This is the first type. Second type, the meristematic tissue which are present at the peripheral region of the stem are called lateral meristem. And the meristematic tissues which are present at the internodal portion or from where leaves are growing, these are called intercalary meristem. Now we will see about permanent tissue. The permanent tissues, these are of two types, simple tissue and complex tissue. Means these are classified into again two types, that are simple tissue and complex tissue. Simple tissues are of three types, parenchymatous, colenchymatous and sclerenchymatous. Means parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma are the simple tissues of the plant, and complex permanent tissues are of two types. These are togetherly called as vascular bundles, in which there is presence of one xylem and second one is the phloem. Thus plant tissues are meristematic and permanent tissues. In meristematic, apical, lateral and intercalary, three types. In case of permanent, there are two types, simple and complex permanent tissues, but these simple permanent tissues are classified as parenchyma, chlorenchyma, sclerenchyma, and complex tissues are divided into two types, xylem and phloem. Now we will see about the actual where these meristematic tissues are present. We have seen already three types, in which this is apical, means tip portion. This portion is the tip portion, at tip portion of the stem and at the tip portion of the root, this apical meristem is present. Here this is the part, that is nodal part, from where leaf is originating, that is called intercalary meristem. And the meristematic tissues which are present at the lateral or peripheral portion of the stem or the branch, that is called as lateral meristem. Now, only certain parts of the plant tend to grow, and the tissues located in such a growing part is called as the meristematic tissues. They have the capability to divide themselves and form new tissues. They are made from the cellulose and they have dense nucleus, cytoplasm, but lack of the vacuoles. Now we will see the difference between apical meristem, lateral and intercalary meristem. As you know, these apical meristem, these are present at the growing part of the stems and roots, and they are found at the tips of roots and stem. In case of lateral, they are responsible for increasing the circumference of the middle part, that is girth of the stem. Hence, are found there at the lateral part. But in case of intercalary meristem, these tissues are present at the internodal part and or the stem regions between the places at which leaves attach. Why there are no vacuoles in the intercalary meristem? We have seen that in meristematic tissues there is no vacuole. Vacuoles are responsible for storage of the food and water. Thus, food and water. The intercalary tissues do not have the vacuoles. They are rather responsible for manufacturing of them. Moreover, vacuoles contain sap which provides rigidity to the cell, and this property of the vacuole may not allow the intercalary tissues to divide and manufacture new cells. Hence, vacuoles are absent in intercalary meristem. So the reason, have you understood? The reason is that they are involved in the responsible for manufacturing of storage of food and water, and due to which they provide the rigidity to the cell, and this property of the vacuole may not allow the intercalary tissues to divide and manufacture the new cell. Thus, they do not have the vacuole. Now, we will see about permanent tissues. These cells are formed by the meristematic tissues only. They lose their ability to divide and form more cells. Then they become permanent tissues of the plant. What is the differentiation? The process by which the cells of meristematic tissues convert them into permanent tissue by taking fixed shape, size and function is called as the differentiation. Means, have you understood the definition of differentiation of the cells? The process by which cells of the meristematic tissues convert them into permanent tissues by taking fixed shape, size and function, that is differentiation. We have seen their types, simple and permanent tissues. Here, from the simple tissues, we have seen three types, that is parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. These parenchymatous cells are thin-walled. They have intracellular spaces. In case of colenchyma, there are no intracellular spaces because they become rigid by depositing some chemical substance. In case of sclerenchyma, all the intracellular space is become rigid due to the means lignin substance which is deposited. Thus, from this diagram, you can easily differentiate all these parenchymatous and colenchymatous cells. Now, we will see the actual difference between these three simple tissues, that is parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Here we will see about parenchyma. These tissues are responsible for photosynthesis, storage of the food and gaseous exchange and floating of the plant. Parenchymatous cells, they are a group of living cells with cell wall made up of cellulose. The parenchymatous cells have large intercellular space between them and their walls are thin surround each cell. Therefore, these are elastic or flexible. Now, we will see about colenchyma. Colenchymatous cells, these are responsible for providing flexibility. They can bend easily. They are a group of living cells with cell wall made up of cellulose and pectin substance. Colenchyma, they have little intercellular space in between them. The cells present in these tissues are broad and irregularly thick at the corners. Now, we will see about sclerenchymatous cells. Sclerenchyma, these tissues are responsible for making plants hard and rigid. They are made up of dead cells having cell wall made up of lignin. The cells do not have any intercellular space. The cells have long structure with thick walls and they are found in the stem, veins, leaves, coverings of the nuts and the seed. Means these all portions are hard portions. But in case of colenchyma, they are present in leaves and stems of the plant. In case of parenchyma, they are found in leaves and newly formed branches. Here you can see about this colenchyma and parenchyma. These are the tissues similar to that of parenchyma, but they also contain chlorophyll in it. Due to presence of chlorophyll, they are capable to form the food in case of the plant by photosynthesis process. Now, what is parenchyma? They are found in the aquatic plants. They are similar structure to that of parenchyma, and they have large air in it. These cavities, air cavities, allow the aquatic plants to float in the water. Means these parenchymatous cells, means these are nothing but parenchymatous cells present in the aquatic plant. And aquatic plant means these are continuously present in the water in order to avoid its decomposition due to continuous contact with the water. There are presence of air cavities inside them, and these air cavities which are present in the parenchyma help the plant, aquatic plant, to float in water. The cell wall of dead cells have a substance called as lignin in them, which provide rigidity to the cell. Lignin acts as cement for the cell. Now, epidermis. The outermost layer of the cell is known as epidermis. It covers the entire plant. It is a thin layer of single cell, but in places with less water, the epidermis become thick in order to avoid frequent water loss. The cells are flat and they have no intercellular spaces between them. The outer walls of the epidermal cells are thick and inner walls are thin. We can see its diagram as well as some important point. Epidermal cells often have long hair-like structures in the roots, which facilitate them to absorb the water. The main function of epidermis is to protect the plant from fungi, water, and from the injuries by secretion of wax-like water-resistant substance that is called cuticle on the roots of the plant, which protect the plant. Now we can see the transverse section of the epidermis. In this section you can see three epidermal layer: upper epidermal, middle means meso, and lower means this epidermis upper layer. On this upper layer there is deposition of chemical substance that is cuticle. Below that there is upper epidermis, middle epidermis is called as mesophyll, and bottom part of this epidermal layer is called as lower epidermal layer. Now you can see those three parts of the epidermis: upper, middle, and lower epidermal cell. Now in this upper, this deposition on the cell is called as cuticle. Then middle part, this part is palisade parenchyma, and here you can see all different types of the shells. How here in the middle, the space which is present where diffusion of the gases takes place, here you will see easily. Now in this palisade parenchyma there is spongy parenchyma also. On the margin of this leaf you can see the minute holes, and that minute holes are called as the stoma. This stoma, this minute hole, that is stoma. This stoma is guarded by the cell that is called as guard cell. Now you can see the next part. Stomata are pore-like structures that are present in the epidermis of the leaves. These pores are enclosed by two cells that have a similar shape as kidney. These are called as guard cells of stomata. Guard cells are modified epidermal cells. These guard cells are responsible for the exchange of the gases and transpiration. Now we will discuss about the transpiration part, which is important for the Olympiad competition exam. We will see that what is transpiration in the plant. The loss of water is called as the transpiration. It may be by due to the sunlight. Whole day the plants are standing in the sunlight. Due to heat from the sunlight, the extra amount of water or the water from the plant body get lost. That loss of water is called as the transpiration in the plant. Actually, this mineral and water is taken by the plant by the roots. Thus, water absorbed by the root hairs and it is taken in upward direction towards the leaf or tip portion of the stem. This is the circulation of the water or transportation of the water from the root to the all parts of the plant body. The plant cells, when sometime have extra, they lose it in the form of the water, evaporate through the stomata. This process is called as the transpiration. Role of transpiration in the plant. It is according to the Olympiad exam. You can see that transpiration role is that due to this transpiration, exchange of the gases takes place. It prevents the plant from overeating. It also transports the food and water in the plant and movement of the water in the plant. So, plants absorb carbon dioxide and release oxygen through the transpiration. It also prevents from overeating. Leaves absorb sunlight during the photosynthesis. Some of it is used in the photosynthesis process while rest is used at heat energy. We know that absorption of water causes cooling of the surrounding. Therefore, transpiration keeps the leaves cool. Transportation of the food and water. With the help of the water, the roots of the plant absorb the water present in it. Thus, they are then disturbed through the transpiration stream. But it isn't happen. Movement of the water in the plant. As plants lose water in the form of water vapors, there is loss of water takes place through the leaves. But the water in the leaves become low, so the water from the higher density areas, such as move up to the lower density areas through a force, is called as transpirational pool. Now we will see about which gas is necessary for the process of photosynthesis. The carbon dioxide gas is necessary for the photosynthesis because plant takes carbon dioxide and water in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, and they produces glucose from carbon dioxide and water. Why do plants in desert areas have waxy coating on cutane over them? The epidermal cells of the plant that are found in the deserts have waxy coating of because it prevents water loss from the plant surface, since water is already in the scarce condition, because these areas are called scanty areas, and at scanty areas the amount of water is very less, and due to loss of more water due to this desert area and hot sunlight, Epidermal cells of the plant found in the desert have waxy coating on it. This is the adaptation found in the plant leaves in the desert areas. Why do branches of old trees are different than the stems of new plant? As plant grows older, the meristematic cells start covering the upper layer instead of the epidermis, and these dead cells that have no special function in the plant, but they have the rigidity. They make the branches of the plant thick. This is often called bark of the thick or cork of the tree. The bark of this tree contains substance called as suberin, which makes it very thick and do not allow the gaseous exchange. Now, what are the complex permanent tissues? These comprise of different kinds of the cells. They coordinate each other and perform a common function in them. The tissues are called as xylem and phloem. Here you can see both the diagram of xylem and phloem. There are different components in the xylem and phloem. Xylem has also four component and phloem has also four component. In xylem, there are perforated plates, tracheids, fibers and vessels. Here, xylem parenchyma means they have different plates. Xylem parenchyma, xylem tracheids, xylem fiber and xylem vessels. In case of phloem, phloem have companion cell, sieve plate, fiber and sieve tubes. Thus, the components of the xylem are sieve element or sieve tube, companion cells, sieve plate, phloem fibers and phloem parenchyma. What is the similarities between xylem and phloem? Their main function is to carry food and water in the plant. Both have vascular bundle, which is conductive tissue in the plant that helps them to survive in different environmental conditions. Now, about xylem, it is made up of dead cells having thick cell lining. It consists of following elements. Tracheids and vessels, they have broad tubular structure so that we can allow transportation of the food and water in the plants vertically. In case of xylem parenchyma, it stores food and helps in transportation of water horizontally in the plant. Xylem fibers, they support transportation. Now, what about phloem? Phloem is made up of living cells and it allows the movement of food from leaves to the other parts of that plant. The second component of the phloem, that is sieve tubes. They are broad shaped cells and porous. Companion cells, they facilitate the function of the sieve tubes. Phloem fibers, they provide flexibility to the problem. Phloem fibers, they provide flexibility to the phloem. And phloem parenchyma, they stores starch and proteins in phloem parenchyma. Thus, these are important points about plant cells. Here, collectively, we will see the difference between xylem and phloem according to the point by which it is made up of, what about its thickness, then by which material it is formed, How is its permeability, cytoplasm, transports, then carried out, and direction of flow? Now we will see the differences. Xylem made up of dead cell, phloem from living cell. Xylem cells are thick, phloems are thin. Xylem, there is deposition of lignin substance on the corners, and phloem, it is made up of cellulose. Xylem, it is impermeable, but phloem tissues are permeable. Xylem, they do not have cytoplasm lining, but phloem has cytoplasma lining. Xylem is involved in transportation of water and minerals from the root throughout the from the root. In case of phloem, they are involved in the transportation of the food. In case of xylem, it is present in the leaves. It is the green part of the plant, and phloem, it is grow parts which they are grow. For example, growing parts and storage organs. Movement of the water in case of xylem in upward direction, and its direction about food and water, it is up and down. The tissue also has fibers, but in case of phloem, the food transport from up and down, and its component is companion cell.